Dr. Anthony Fauci predicts the Johnson & Johnson vaccine will be available this week. The CDC recommended a pause after 6 women developed blood clots in their brains. Dr. Fauci says he would be surprised if Johnson & Johnson isn't in use again by this Friday. So blood clots are being discussed more and more, especially for those who already received the Johnson & Johnson vaccine. Here to talk about what causes blood clots and how the vaccine may have caused them is Dr. Stephanie Windish. She is a SLUCare cardiologist. Good morning to you.
Hi, good morning. Thanks for having me on.
Absolutely. You know, we've heard from the medical community that these blood clots are rare. I mean, only 6 people out of some 7 million who received the vaccine actually developed clots. But there's still a fear out there. What's your take on all of this?
Yeah, that's a good point. The vaccine that caused, or is not even caused, associated with those blood clots is very, very rare. But the risk of developing blood clots over time is not quite as rare, especially if you get COVID or you have modifiable risk factors such as smoking or obesity. So talking about blood clots is important, but also talking about getting the vaccines and continuing to get approved vaccinations is just as important.
Yeah, Dr. Windish, we also had an NCAA referee pass out in the middle of a March Madness game. I mean, this guy was otherwise healthy. Is there concern about that?
Yeah, anytime that you have an event like that called syncope in the medical terms or passing out, there's a lot of different causes for it. Most are benign, but when you find that you have a blood clot, you need to talk to your physician or any SLUCare cardiologist about your individual risk for developing blood clots and how you go forward treating those in the future.
Yeah, I mean, what causes clots and how can we cut down on our risks?
Yeah, there's a lot of reasons. Again, smoking, obesity, active cancers, long prolonged times not moving can predispose you for developing blood clots.
I mean, did you find that with these vaccines, maybe we're a bit too hyper-focused as we're looking at them? Maybe we're looking at this out of proportion?
Yeah, you know, the safety of vaccines is the number one important thing that the FDA and the CDC looks at. And so anytime there's an adverse event with the vaccination, they need to look into due diligence to make sure that the vaccine is not causing the blood clots and that it's just a correlation that they're finding. And that's what it seems that the CDC is finding. And that's what Dr. Fauci is addressing and saying that they'll likely be back on the market.
Yeah, Dr. Windish, I mean, what would you say to someone who, once the Johnson & Johnson vaccine is back out there, would you say they're safe to take it?
If the FDA and the CDC approve it for use, I would recommend getting vaccinated against COVID, whichever vaccine you're offered. It's much more efficacious to you to take the vaccine versus getting COVID.
Yeah, and finally, just to remind people, you know, certainly to take care of yourself. I mean, don't put off getting blood work done.
Exactly. Yep. Follow up with your primary care doctor. All these preventative maintenance things are just as important now in the pandemic as they ever were.
Absolutely. Dr. Windish, thank you so much for your time this morning. We appreciate it.
All right. Thank you, guys. Take care.
For more information about the vaccines or to schedule an appointment, we also have a link on fox2now.com.